Hello everybody. The title of this series is the Complete Queen Amidala Style Book. And what we're going to be doing is looking at all the different wardrobes Queen Amidala wore in Episode 1, Phantom Menace. Now there were about 6 or 7 different wardrobes, and they all had what I'll call official names. You had the throne room robe, the lilac visitation robe, the Senate robe, the foreign residence robe, the traveling robe, and the jubilation dress. And it would take much too long to cover all of them in one video, and I've broken it up into different parts. Each part will generally discuss one particular garment. The garment we're going to talk about in this video is the throne room, sometimes called the regal robe. Now, the official description of this garment is that it was Amidala's throne room robe and was the most lavish of all of the different wardrobes and designed to delight visiting dignitaries from other worlds. She wore this when she spoke to the Trade Federation Viceroy Newt Gunray and the Naboo Royal Advisory Council during the invasion of Naboo. Now, this is the first garment that we see her wear in the film. In fact, this is the first time we even see Queen Amidala in the film on that monitor device when she was talking to Newt Gunray. Then they switch back to the throne room and we get a better, clearer picture of the garment. Now, mind you, she's sitting throughout all of this, so we never see her standing in the full breadth of the garment. And we can only really appreciate that through promotional pictures that the studio provided. Now, I must say I consider this to be the most iconic of all of her garments. When you think back to her wardrobes, I think this is probably the wardrobe that most commonly comes to mind and the garment that most people associate with her lavish wardrobe changes. And some of that might be due to the fact that it's, you know, red with black and gold trim. Obviously, it's the most lavish, the most ornate, has the most embellishments. Also, there's an accompanying headgear that complements the very provocative makeup that she's wearing. The promotional pictures also go into further detail about the hairstyling from the back that you might not see. Another little detail are these small globes that you see at the base of the garment. Of course, you don't see these in the film because she was sitting down the whole time. We never see her standing. And at first glance, they just seem like little globe-like embellishments. But in further promotional pictures, we see that they can actually illuminate. Of course, we'd never appreciate that in the film, but apparently they have that capability. Now, you could argue it's quite a curious feature of the garment because it really would not seem to have any practical purpose. So as I said before, I consider this particular wardrobe my favorite. So I hope you enjoyed this presentation of this particular garment. As I said earlier, this is the first installment of a number of installments in where I'm going to be talking about each one of those garments from Episode 1, Phantom Menace. So please subscribe to the channel to ensure that you receive these next installments, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.